Hope you're having a good weekend so far. We start out here with a look live on Chestnut Street in Meadville into Crawford County. The wind has picked up. That means temperatures are going up tonight. So it's going to be much different as we go into the second half of the weekend on Sunday. So technically speaking, the high temperature is technically where we're at right now. I know that says 58, but with south wind, numbers have just been going up. And I think that trend continues as we go into the overnight hours. 62 from Doc Tom at Niagara Pier. You make your way towards Penn State Barron over to Northeast, upper 50s to near 60. It is 55 right now in Corey, 57 in Union City. Numbers into Crawford County tonight are in the mid-upper 50s, Meadville over to Espyville, and then into Warren County, numbers here as well, in the mid-50s at last check. So here's the setup. Got a couple of scattered showers pass by. Warm front nearby. And this warm front is kind of just to the north of us. And I think that's where it's going to reside tomorrow. So that should easily put us in the warm sector, which means numbers on Sunday will be much warmer compared to where they were on Saturday. So here it is. Maps in motion for you. There's the warm front right there again, hanging out just north of us. And really, the dividing line between cool 40s and 50s to the north and 60s, 70s to the south. As long as that front's nearby, I can't completely rule out a passing shower. What happens on Monday? Well, the front starts to play with us a little bit here. And there's going to be a ripple of low pressure that develops along it. And this low will sweep through. And watch as we go into Monday afternoon. You'll see some darker oranges and yellows here. You're going to notice the humidity increase on Monday, and there could be some downpours. So the front off to the north of us tomorrow, it will start to sag south tomorrow night into Monday. That ripple of low pressure rides along it, and then the front lifts back to the north on Tuesday. So with the front to the north on Tuesday, we have another opportunity to get to near or over 70. Now coming up on Tuesday, it could be a little interesting. So we're going to have a couple disturbances and an approaching cold front. So we're going to have to watch for the possibility of maybe some locally strong weather Tuesday. We'll keep you posted. It's still a couple days away, so we have time to kind of look over things a little bit more in depth. So tonight, numbers are going up. Tomorrow, maybe a shower early, and then maybe one more isolated shower somewhere in the afternoon. Breezy and warmer for the afternoon, high 72 to 78. And then tomorrow night's breezy and mild. A few showers are likely. Lows 55 to 60. Okie doke, 7-day forecast. So again, a bit humid Monday, downpours, upper 60s. Scattered thunderstorms Tuesday, 70. Leftover rain shower Wednesday, then the sky clears and much cooler as we go into late week with highs in the 50s. YourErie.com, click on weather latest updated forecast right there under the weather tab. So precipitation associated with warm fronts most often occurs where in relation to the front, Brian? Ahead, behind, right along it, or does it happen on both sides?
Wow. I'm going to say behind the warm front.
And that would be a cold front, my man. Nice try, though. It's ahead of the warm front as we get that overrunning effect with warm fronts. So that's commonly where you'll find wet weather and clouds and drizzle.